Hey guys, it's Nick, and today I'm going to be starting a new tutorial video on flag, and unlike the other one where I just did a couple of tosses, I'm going to go through all the basics, and I'm going to go through the same flag tosses that I did before, and I'm going to add a couple new ones too. So I'm going to be going over everything on flag, so it'll be a tutorial video that you can come and look at whenever you're having trouble with anything like a certain toss or things with the basics that you just need to go over. And so I'm hoping that this video will help a lot of people who are learning how to do color guard and who are unable to do these tosses at the moment. And just hoping that it helps out. So we'll get right to it then. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you what the parts of the flag are. So tab, top tape, bottom tape, bottom tip, top tip, and silk and pulp. So that's gonna be how I refer to these tosses and exercises. So if you need help remembering what part of the pole is which, just refer back to that and you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. So the first thing that I'm gonna show you is called a drop spin. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna start, your right hand is under at the tab and your left hand is over at the bottom tip. And you're gonna start flat. The flag is gonna be parallel to, it's gonna be parallel to the ground, and it's gonna be right in front of your hips. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna count 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, and then on 8 you're gonna go up to a right percent, which just means that right shoulder. And what that means is your right hand is at the tab, and your left hand is at the bottom tip, and your right hand is the one that's up. The shoulder that's working the flag, that's making it stand straight up and down. So you're gonna go to a right shoulder on 8. So 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, up, 8. And then on 8 hand, what you're gonna do is you're going to let go with your left hand on 8 hand, and you're going to put it to your side. You're gonna make it flush with your leg, and you're gonna press it, is what it's called, press. And you're going to lower the flag just a little bit until it matches your forehead, because at 8 your left hand, which was at tip, is at your American Eagle jeans, is what we call them, but they're your hips. It's where your American Eagle jeans would rest if you were wearing them. So it's at your hips, and your right hand at the tab is gonna be just slightly above your forehead. And what you're gonna do is when you let go, you're gonna lower your right hand to your forehead, and you're going to tilt it onto the left angle. The silk should be to the left and it should be up, and the pole should be to the right angle and down. So this is 8 hands. So 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, up, 8 hands. Now on 1, you're just gonna keep on turning the flag, and you're gonna take your left hand once it gets straight up and down, and it's gonna be about at your belly button is where your right hand is gonna come to rest whenever you stop spinning it and it's straight up and down. With your left hand, you're going to stick it straight out, and you're gonna put a thumbs down. That's what you wanna think about, is having a thumbs down. And you are going to grab the silk just below the other hand. And you're gonna grab under your other hand. Always grab under when you're doing drop spins. So this is count 1. So 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, up, 8, and 1. So that's count 1, it's gonna be straight up and down, and you're gonna stop the pull. Now, to get to count 2, you're gonna let go with your right hand, and you're going to go through flat. This is count 1 hand. And then you're gonna keep rotating it to 2, and you're gonna grab under, and you're gonna grab thumbs up, as if you're giving a thumbs up to somebody, and you're gonna grab at just a little bit under the tab, because you're gonna keep rotating it on to get to 3. You're gonna let go with your left hand, go to 2 hand, which is again flat, and you're going to grab just like you did on count 1, at the tab. You're gonna give a thumbs down at the tab, and you're gonna grab. And you want your hand to be out of the silk, which is why you place your right hand just under the tab on count 2, because you wanna make room for your hand to be out of the silk by count 3. So from the very beginning, it's 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, up, 8, and 1, 2, and 3. Now you could just keep going and going and going, because it's just the same motion repeated over and over and over again. And really, the only way to just remember how to do drop spins is to continually do them. So what you could do is you could think of a song that's got a nice good tempo, and you could just start to you could literally just listen to the song, and you can spin drop spins to the song. So 1 and 2, 3 and 4
5, and 6, 7, and 8. And you just do that until your arms are tired. And the next time, you keep going until your arms are tired again. And eventually, you realize that you can go for longer durations. And that's pretty much the same for anything that you need. So that's the first thing. That's drop spins. The second thing I'm going to show you is called a flourish. I'm going to say you're going to want to start it flat, and you're going to do the same thing you did when you were doing drop spins. So 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, up, 8, and. Now this is where it changes. Instead of going down straight and you're grabbing on one, what you're going to do is you're going to bring it down until it's on the angle. The pole should be going to the right, you should be going up, and the silk should be going to the left, and it should be down, and it's going to be on that angle. This is count one. Now on count one and, you're going to just slide it, you're going to bring it over to the right side of your body, and it's going to be straight up and down, and it's going to be towards your right, towards the end zone. If you do marching band, you know what the end zone is. It's your right, it's the where the football people score. So this is count one and. Now for count two, you're going to just keep on rotating it, and the pole is going to come behind your back, and you're just gonna keep going until the flag silk is up and you're on this angle right here. So this is count two. So from the very beginning, it should go 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, up, 8 and 1 and 2. This is count two. Now count three. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna keep rotating the flag this way, and count three is going to be, you're going to keep rotating it until it's behind you. So on count two, the pole is behind you because you just took it here and you went behind you. That's count two. Now count three, you're just going to take the pole and it's going to the soap and it's going to go behind you again. So from here down. That's count three. Now to get to count four, you're just going to keep rotating it. What you're going to kind of do is bring it from behind you, just in front of you. But instead of just going boop, like this, what you're going to do is you're going to turn your wrist while you're doing it, so it actually makes the flag turn while it's coming over your head. So turn. And so what's going to happen is you're going to turn it until it's flat right there above your head, and then you're going to turn it up all the way. And this is where you'll start over, because this is where 8 and was at the very beginning, 5, 6, 7, 8 and. So the only difference is it's straight up and down, it's not on the angle. So from the very beginning, 5 and 6, 5, 6, 7, up, 8 and, 1, 2, 3, 4 and. So this is 4 and, 4 and. So that is a full flourish. You keep doing it over and over and over again. And you don't have to do song spinning to this one, where you go and you find a song and you just spin to it until your arms are tired. You don't have to, because once you learn how to do it, it's very easy to do. But if you want to, the same thing applies. Just find a good tempo and just keep doing this until your arm gets tired. And you could learn it off the left side of your body too. I never really did that because I've never had to, so it's a little harder for me to do that. But you could totally learn it off the left side of your body and it would have the same effect. And if you do learn it off the left side of your body, that's great. So those are flourishes. The next thing I'm going to show you is a cone. So for a cone, what you're going to do is you're going to go to a right shoulder hip angle, and it's going to be down. So shoulder hip angle just means that the pole itself is on an angle, but your hand placements, wherever they are on the pole, are in relation to your shoulder. So in your hand, so you might see my left hand is over at the bottom tips, and it's at my left shoulder, and my right hand is under at the tab, so both of the thumbs are going to be facing down towards the silk, and it's at my right hip. So it's called a shoulder hip because they're at the shoulder and the hip. We can also call this a seat belt, because that's what it's going to be related to whenever people are giving analogies to it. To make it a good shoulder hip angle, you want to think that it's a seat belt while you're driving, that it would save you if you were to get into a car wreck. If you have it too high, you could slip under. If you have it too low, you would flip over. So you want it to be just right, so that way if you get into a car wreck, you just hit it and you won't fly through your windshield. So this is a shoulder hip angle. This is where you're going to start for cones. And what you're going to do on count one, so 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, on 8 and, you're going to go through flat, but instead of being flat and straight to the front, you're going to kind of have your top tip pointed towards the 45. The 45 is just a corner. Your 45 is your left corner, your right corner, your back left corner, and your back right corner. Those are your 45s. So you're going to kind of have your top tip pointing towards your right front 45 as you're going to count 1. Count 1 is this right here. Pick picture that you're trying to make here. This is called front present. Your left hand isn't going to be touching your body. It's going to be a little bit away from it, but you don't want to bend over to get that flag away from you. You want it stepping straight up and down. And it's hard for some people because they've got shorter arms than others, but just try your hardest not to bend over when you're getting into that position. And that's count one, so five and six, five, six, seven, eight, and one. So that's count one. Now what you're going to do is you're going to hold this for two, three, and four. So five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, and four. Now on four and, you're going to get right here. You're going to cross your arms across your body to where your left hand is at your right hip and your right hand is over towards your left temple. Now this is called your window count, and it's four and it's called your window because if you were to peer your head through this, it kind of looks like you're looking through a window. So if you're hitting this window count, it means you're doing it right. If you're not, it means you're not doing it right. And you want to hit that window count because if you're not doing it right, it's going to mess up how the cone looks. So make sure you hit this on forehand, your window count. Now, you're just going to keep rotating the flag to count five. And when you get there, this is called a back present. It's another 3D picture because if I were to look at the back, it's not a flat picture. It looks like a coming at you. Your left arm, is going to be parallel to the ground. It's going to be flat. Like you could hold a pizza box on it and it wouldn't fall over. So it's going to be flat. And your right arm is going to be straight up. It's not going to be bent because then it's going to look like that and it's going to look a little flat. You want to have it completely straight. And if you look at it, it looks like there's a right triangle in my arm. Right here, it looks like I'm making a right triangle. And it should look like that. So this is count five. So let's do that from the beginning. Five and six. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five. So that's count five. Now you're gonna hold here for six, seven, and eight, just like you did for two, three, and four on the other one. So five, six, seven, eight. Now on eight and, you're going to keep your arms straight and you're just gonna turn the flag. Don't bend your arms to do that. Just keep it straight. And you're gonna make them flat, the pole flat, and it's gonna be about at your eye level, maybe your forehead. And this is going to be your eight hand. Now you're just going to keep on turning your arms to a down present. This is what it looks like. It's another 3D image. And it's the same thing as this. You want to make another right triangle. Your right arm this time is going to be the one that's parallel to the ground. Your left arm is going to be the one that's completely straight up. Don't bend your left arm. Don't sag your flag. Don't make it go to the ground. Don't make it go up. You want it to be flat to the ground. So this is count nine. So from the very beginning, so five and six. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, and nine. So that's count nine. Now you're gonna hold here again, 10, 11, and 12. And on 12 and, you're gonna cross your arms again to make another window count. Your right hand is gonna be at your left hip, and your left hand is gonna be at your right temple. So another window count, you gotta hit it. And then you're just gonna keep unwinding, and you're gonna start end where you started. And you're gonna hold here for third, fourth, and fifth. So from the very beginning, five and six, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight, and nine, 10, 11, 12, and third, fourth, fifth, six. And that's a whole cone, and you could start over and just keep doing them. Now, those are what's called augmented cones, because you're hitting a position, you're stopping, and you're holding it, and then you're hitting it again, and you're stopping it, and holding it, and you're just doing that over and over and over again. So that's why it's called augmented, because it's in separate pieces. Now you can do something else called a slow cone, which means that it's not augmented, it's all flowed and it's all connected. You never stop, you never hit a single position. It's all just connected. So those look like this, five and six, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, and third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Now those are augmented and slow fours. Because you're counting in fours, you're hitting each position every four counts, you see? So you're hitting here, and then here every four counts. You could also do that in twos, augmented and slow twos. So five and six augmented, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, four, and five, six, and seven, eight. Those are augmented twos because you're hitting every position and you're holding it for just a second. And then the slow twos are just five and six, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And those are cones. You can do them augmented or smooth or slow. Slow, smooth, you could call it either one. So those are cones. Next thing I'm gonna be teaching you are called pull hits. So what you're gonna do is you're going to have your right hand is going to be thumb up towards the bottom tip at the tab, and the silk is going to be down towards the vent. Your left hand is going to be thumb towards the bottom tip, and it's going to be at the bottom tape. Now what you're going to do is your right hand is going to be kind of at your hips and kind of at your belly button, depending on who you are, and your left hand is going to be right in front of your eyes. Now what you're going to do is you're going to make, without the flag, you're going to make this motion right here. Boom. You're going to pull it apart, and you're going to want to make the flag turn when you do that. So, buh and buh is what you're going to be doing, essentially. So, with the flag, you're going to pull like this, and you're just going to buh and buh. And that's a pull hit. And you should catch in the same place that you started, so buh and buh. So, right hand at tap, left hand at bottom tape. Now, you should toss on one, so 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. And you should catch on two, so 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2. So it's just a very quick sort of toss. You can do them over and over and over again. You can actually song spin with these. So you would just go 1, 2, hold 3, 4, and 5, 6, hold 7, 8. And you just keep doing that over and over and over and over again until your arms get tired. And that's a really good way to build up your arm muscle and get used to how tosses feel. Now, a pop toss, which is the first toss that I'm gonna be teaching you, is basically just a pull hit, but higher. And it's got more rotations to it. So to do a pop toss, you start in the same place as you would a pull hit, and instead of just pulling it apart, you're actually going to pull down with your left hand until, and you actually want to pull. Like if I were to just keep my right hand in the same place, it would actually hit the ground. That's how hard I'm pulling it. And so you pull and you actually press your hand to the right, to your leg. And when I say press, it means your whole hand. It has to be completely straight. You don't want to have it bent like this because that looks a little tense. And you don't want to have it off to the side like this or anything like that. You actually want to have it pressed because that tells you that you're using the right amount of energy, right? And so you're going to pull down and you're going to press. And with your right hand, you're going to actually punch up towards the sky. And you're going to do them at the exact same time. So you're going to pull down and you're going to punch up at the exact same time. And you really want to actually punch it up there. And you want to get it there in one count. You don't want to be like, because then your toss isn't going to be right and it's not going to rotate the full amount. And you're going to feel like you're doing it wrong. And you are. So what you're going to do is, boom, see how they hit both positions at the exact same time? That's what you want. And so the toss is going to look like this. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3. So it should be about 3 counts, depending on how fast you're counting. And so you release on 1, you catch on 3. It should catch in the exact same way that you would, that you started in, and you should, it's gonna rotate twice in the air. So when I say rotates, it means the silk goes up, and then you catch. So it rotates twice, 1, 2, and squeeze, which is why it's 3 counts. 1, 2, and squeeze. And that's a pop toss. Now, the next toss I'm gonna be teaching you is called a money hand toss. Now, for a money hand toss, what you're gonna do is you're going to take your left hand, and you're gonna put it at your tab. Up towards the silk. Silk's gonna be up towards the sky. Now what you're gonna do with your right hand is, it's called a money hand toss because your right hand, it's extended out like this, like you're asking for money. Now what you're gonna do is you're just gonna take your thumb and you're gonna take it away from the rest of your hand. And where you started before, you're just going to split the tape. And when I say split the tape, it means you're splitting top and bottom tape. So just go in between those two tapes, and that's called splitting the tape. So this is where you're gonna start for a money hand toss. What you're gonna do is you're gonna pull down with your left hand and you're gonna press it. Now see how I'm swinging the flag like this? That's the kind of motion that you want whenever you're tossing. So pull down and swing. Now your right hand is going to punch the sky again, just like you were doing with the pop toss. So, but. And it's gonna kinda feel like two separate motions, but. But you wanna make sure that it's as much of one motion as you can make it, because otherwise it's gonna be too lofty and you're not gonna be able to get the full rotation of the flag out, and it's not gonna be right. So you have to pull and you have to push. The rotation of the flag is gonna come from your left hand. If you're not pulling hard enough, you're not gonna get the full rotation out. And the height of the flag is gonna come from your right hand. So if you're just stopping right here, it's not gonna get really high. You have to go pretty high to get it to go really, really high. So to show you the toss, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 3. So that is a money hand toss. And you'll catch about the same time as you would a pop toss on count 3. And so that is a money hand toss. The next toss I'm gonna teach you is called a J toss, and it's basically the same thing as a money hand toss. The only difference is you're not using your left hand very much. So everything comes from your right hand. Sure, you're probably gonna do this while you're in a show, because it looks really awkward to set up like this all the time, and it's really hard to hold that flag there. But for a J toss, basically you're gonna set up like a money hand toss, and you're just gonna take your left hand off. Now, to get the toss out, you have to swing it as if it was pulled by the left hand. So, boom, to get it up. Now, to get the rotation out, because you don't have your left hand to get that rotation out, you have to make up for it with your right hand. And to do that, what you have to do is you have to flick your wrist really fast. So, boom, and flick to get it out. So, to show you, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and ah! See how it flicked it? Yeah, so 5, 6, one more time, 5, 6, 7, 8, and ah! And squeeze. And that's a J toss. It's called a J because you make a J with your hand. Now, the next toss I'm gonna be teaching you is a strip toss. So, what you're gonna do, it's called a strip toss because you start the toss out by stripping the silk up the pole. Now, what you're gonna do is, you're gonna strip it as far as you want to, but whenever you learn it, I recommend you learn it all the way to the tip. So strip the silk all the way to the tip. What you're gonna do is you're gonna start with both thumbs pointing down towards the bottom tip. And what you're gonna do is you're going to push up with your right hand on the flag until it's straight up and down, and you're gonna grab it like a money hand toss. Grab it like this, and you're gonna go about 2/3 of the way into the silk from the tab and 1/3 of the way from the tip. So about right here. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna let go with your left hand, and you're gonna act like it's a J toss, and you're just going to out. Oops, so sorry. So, out. Now what you're gonna do, it's gonna be a very lofty toss. It's not supposed to be one of those tosses that goes whoosh and squeeze. It's one of the ones that goes woo, and then it's up there for a little while, and then you squeeze it. It's very slow, it's very lofty. So what you're gonna do is strip, up, and out, and squeeze. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and out. And that is a strip toss. The next toss that I'm gonna be teaching you is called a flag double. Now what you're gonna do, it incorporates cones. This is where cones are important to tossing. What you're gonna do is you're going to take your left hand and you're gonna split the two tapes and you grab thumbs down towards the silk. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take the right hand and stick it under the pole, and about 1/3 of the way into the silk, you're gonna grab under your thumb is gonna be down towards the silk. Now you're gonna do a cone. And your arm, the goal is to make your arm straight when you do it, but most of the time when you're actually doing it in context, your arm is going to end up bending. So when you're learning it, try and make your arm straight, but don't worry if your arm's bent because it's not really going to affect the toss that much. Now, what you want to think about, instead of doing this and going like really high with it, or doing this and just doing a little baby one, or doing this and going over, you want to think that there's, you know how when witches are casting spells and they're big cauldrons, and they're like turning it like this, you want to think that you're doing that with the flag. You want to turn the pot. You want to just turn the pot. And so that's your cone, so here, and then you're going to go down to a shoulder hip angle, and you're going to push with your left hand and up with your right hand. And that's actually two separate motions this time. You don't want it to be one motion, it's two separate motions. So push up, and you'll actually hear it in the flag when you toss it, because it goes whoosh, whoosh, and then it goes up. So when you're doing it, you wanna think, instead of turning your wrist down here and then pushing up, you wanna think you're already up and then you're twisting your wrist. And that's where the second whooshing sound comes from. So it goes up, turn, instead of turn up. So five, so from the very beginning, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. You hear it, it goes whoosh, whoosh. It's 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and up. I'll say it one more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, whoosh, whoosh, and squeeze. And that is a flag double. So the next toss I'll be showing you is called a cross toss. And so what you're gonna do is you're going to start with your right hand at the tab with your thumb pointing down towards the bottom tip. Your left hand is going to be probably about splitting, and your thumb is gonna be facing down towards the pole. Now you're going to put the flag silk up. And so you're thumbs are going to be pointing towards the ground. It's going to feel a little uncomfortable, but that's okay. If it feels uncomfortable, it means you're doing it right. What you're going to do is you're just going to cross your arms until the flag is facing straight up again, which is why it's called a cross toss. It's because your arms are crossing. So you cross it, and when it's straight up and down, you let it go. So 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and squeeze. So you'll probably catch on 3-ish around that time, 1, 2, and 3. And depending on what your instructor wants you to do or what you're doing in your show, you'll probably catch it flat, but you could also catch at the angle, and depending on how many rotations you do, it depends on if you're catching in the silk or in the pole. So that's a cross toss. The next tosses that I'm going to be showing you are two variants of a flat toss. So the first one is just called a flat toss, and what you're going to do is you're going to put your thumb at the tab, and it's going to be facing down towards the silk. It doesn't matter which way you're pointing it, because you're going to put the silk onto your shoulder, and you're going to take your left hand and you're going to point it, your thumb, down towards the bottom tip, and you're going to start out like this. Now what you're going to do is you're going to pull the flag up until it's above your head and start turning it until it's flat, right at like probably about forehead level, and you're going to release it. Now don't worry about it hitting your head, because when it rotates in the air, as it starts coming back down, the pole's in front of your head, and it's not above your head, so it's not even in any area where it could hit your head. So don't worry, don't let your fear of it hitting your head hinder how you're tossing. So it should just go boop and there. Oops. So up and there. That's all. Up and there. Now the other toss is called a helicopter toss. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna start with the pole behind the back like this, and the flip's gonna be down towards the ground. And what you're going to do is you're going to raise the pole until it's flat right in front of your face, and you're going to keep turning it and let it go. So turn until it's about right there, and then let it go. So out. Now the next toss I'm going to be showing you is the last toss. It's called a 45 toss. Now what you're going to do is you're going to have your hand at the tab, thumb pointing up towards the bottom tip, and your left hand's going to be at bottom tape, and it's going to be up towards the bottom tip. So your right hand is going to be on your hip where you start, and you're going to raise the pole until it's flat at your eyes. And then this is just a pass through. You're not going to stop here, so you're not going to go boop and then continue. It's just a pass through, so you're going to go here, and then you're going to keep rotating your hands. Keep rotating it, and your left hand is going to be behind your head right about here, and your right hand is going to be up above your head up here, and you want it to be that high up. Now whenever you get to this is your release point. Whenever you get to there, you don't want to look down at the ground, because it's going to make your flag flat, and you don't want it to be flat, because that means that you have a better chance of actually hitting your head. And that's something that you'll be afraid of whenever you actually start tossing, and it'll probably be the only thing that will make it to where you don't want to toss this toss. It'll probably be your only fear in this toss. So you want to make sure you're looking up, and you want to try and spot the tab. You want to look at this while the flag is actually spinning in the air, because then you know that the flag's not going to hit you in the head. So you go to right here, and your left hand, you want to think, for girls and guys with long hair, you want to think, if you were to put your hair into a ponytail, you could grab it with your left hand. That's about where your hand should be on the release point. So your release point is right here, on the side right there, and just let it go. So 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, and squeeze. And you'll catch on 3 again. So 1, 2, and 3. Now, you're gonna catch the flag in the same way that you started. So your right hand is gonna be at the tab, and your left hand is gonna be at the bottom tape. All you're gonna do is you're gonna switch your hands. So now your thumbs are pointing up towards the silk instead. And you're gonna catch it on the left side of your body. So if you're starting on the right side and you're tossing, you're gonna catch it on your left side. So it's supposed to go across your body. Boom. Now, there are different ways that you can do a 45 toss. Like, you could just add a little bit more to it, and you can get a 45 one and a half out. And all you would have to do is, you would catch the same way, but instead the silk would be down. You would catch about 2/3 of the way into the silk, and you would catch at the tab, or you can catch 1/3 of the way into the silk, and you can catch at the bottom tape. Now, you could also start the toss out from the top tape and the bottom tip, and that will allow you to get that 1.5 out a lot smoother. But you could also do a double with that. A double. Now, you can also do one-handed 45s, which to do that, you would have to be about either at the top tape, or you would be about splitting on the pole. I typically do top tape. And you would have the flag behind you back like this. And what you would do is you would bring it down towards the right end zone, the wall, and you would bring it up. And then you would go to the release point, and your hand again would want to grab that ponytail if you were to have it. So from right here, like that, and from the side, it'll look like this. And then you'll just release it. If you want to just do a single, you don't put any sort of power behind it, you just let it fly. So you just get to the release point and let it go. Boom, and squeeze, single. If you wanted to do a single and a half, just add a little bit of power to the toss. Boom, boom, one half. If you wanted to do a double, you just add even more power. Boom, double. And you can keep going up. Like, the highest I've ever seen someone toss that is a triple. I can do a double and a half, that's about it. Now, you can also do a toss where if you were to start right here, for like a normal 45, you would just put it flat at your hips, you would push down on the pole, and you would make it swing all the way around into your right hand. So push with your right hand and just flip it over. Your left hand is gonna look, it's gonna feel a bit weird, but if it feels weird, that means you did it right. So from here, you're just gonna push up with the right hand. So push it like this. And it's gonna be a three image. It's not gonna be flat, straight up and down. It's gonna be pushed out a little. Then you're gonna swing it down towards your feet. And again, it's 3D, it's not up straight. It's a little bit down and it's gonna be pointing at the feet. And then you're just gonna keep turning the pole until you hit this release point again with your hand wanting to grab your ponytail. So in all, it would look like this. Boom, and up. And you would just release it from there. And it doesn't require you to use any sort of push or turn of the wrist or anything. You just let the pole go because the momentum of swinging the flag around is what gets the toss out. So up, around, and out. Boom. Now if you wanted to make it a little bit more, then you could add a little bit of look at the finger just to make it go a little higher. So here, boom. And that would just make it go a little higher. But those are all the tosses and all the basics that I'm gonna be teaching today. That was a 45 toss. And I hope that this tutorial video helps you out. If you have any questions, leave a comment. And if you have any requests for me to do, I can try and see what it is. If I know it already, I'll post it. And if I don't know it, I can try and learn it. And then I can post it. If you have any questions about what I've already posted, just comment and I'll see if I can help you out if throughout any confusion. And I just hope this video was helpful to all the people who are trying to learn how to do color guard and spin flag in a very mature way. And thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to me if you like it, and hopefully give me a thumbs up, and have a fantastic time spinning.
Hey guys, one more thing. People have been asking me about the flag silks that I have and telling me that they're really cool, and they're asking me where I get them, how I make them. There's a website called bandtoday.com where they actually sell used flag silks on sale. You can get them pretty cheap, or you can actually design your own flags for about $40 each per silk. So it's a really good deal. I designed 4 flag silks this past year, and I only got one of them because it was so expensive, but it's definitely worth it. And if you want to have a really good flag silk, a really good show, make it really flashy, that's definitely the place I would go. So the website is bandtoday.com. I'll probably be putting a link about right here, and just hope you have fun with it. And bye, guys. So this is our neighborhood cat. His name is Snickers. That's what we named him because he doesn't seem to be anybody's cat. He just likes to roam around our neighborhood. So we kind of named him Snickers one day at the bus stop. And so Snickers decided to come over and watch me today. Hey, Snickers. Oh, Snickers.